Hi everybody, it's your girl Tofu. Welcome back to some more Life is Strange Before the Storm. It's been a hot minute since we've picked this up. I think it's been like a week, which is a huge long time, but things have been happening. It's been crazy, so thank you for your patience. I'm excited to be playing this again because y'all have told me that's going to pick up a little bit in a moment, so that's always something to look forward to. Before we get started, I just want to give a quick, really big shout out to our friend and patron, TGFC, aka Gregory. Gregory, thank you so much for deciding to be a sponsor of this channel and for helping us buy games so we can continue hanging out together. I appreciate it so much. And I'm gonna link, he actually has his own channel, which I'm gonna link right up here somewhere so you guys can see. And let's do it. Let's get into this. I forgot where it was because I'm pretty sure I looked at this last time.
Guess I'll
let's
never
make
see
sure
my
we're
name
good.
In one of these. I wouldn't have made it to senior year anyway.
Oh. So we want to go to room 110, I believe. I think we're going to Drew's room, right? Jesus, I don't know. It's 105. Thou shalt not pass. Thou shalt not pass! I was just thinking about Lord of the Rings. Like, literally, I just recorded Spider-Man a couple hours ago, and I was saying, like, how much I really wanted to do a Lord of the Rings, like, marathon this weekend, so it's a little weird that that's there. I mean, we've been kind of in tune lately with the universe. It's kind of scary. Like, Tex brought it up to me in the comments the other day, and I was just like, you're right. There have been a lot of crazy things that we've been predicted. Too many coincidences for my liking.
Elliot Hampton's room. Wonder what he's up to right now.
Oh, do you think we should go in there?
Could Elliot be lamer if he tried?
It's not lame. It's awesome, okay? Jesus. This seems really like an invasion of privacy. He has like no stuff. A man of simplicity. Interesting. Well, I mean,
Elliot,
it's open. We have to look at it
really hard. I guess I'm happy for him.
Computer science A+. Ooh, smarty.
The world breaks everyone, and afterward, some are strong at the broken places. Why does that make me sad?
Makes me sad too. This is like one of the cleanest rooms, or like most simple anyway. I mean, that's not the cleanest, but like my room doesn't look much better, to be completely honest.
Elliot's mom seems nice.
Is Elliot gonna play a bigger part
Lucky
in all of this,
Dana.
I wonder? Okay, Elliot Hampton to Cynthia Hampton. Hampton. Congratulations. Hey, sweetheart, I just got a letter about your scholarship and I couldn't be prouder. I've been showing it to the whole family. Your grandmother just said, of course he did. He's my grandson. Also, your father called again about July 4th. I told him it was too early to decide that you're focused on school right now anyway. But if you want to spend some time with him this summer, of course I'll support you. Don't break too many hearts over there, Mom. He's the one who's getting his heart broke. Little does she know. Chicks, man. Logan Robertson. What year is this, 2013? I guess they could still use email, but, Yo, Elliot, you got English with Dana Ward, right? What's she like? I heard she's hot. Say something cool about me to her, but not like I told you to do it. Thanks, bruh.
Warren Graham.
From Warren!
Such a nerd.
It's from Warren! Regarding. Or reply. Worst movies ever. You're so wrong. I'll grant you, Ed Wood has made some awful movies, but so many even more awesomely terrible movies came out from Plan 9, after Plan 9, from Outer Space. It's called the worst movie ever made, but have you seen Night of the Lepus? What's a bunch of space zombies compared to giant carnivorous rabbits, Warren? Ed, totally. Huh. Warren's the best.
There's way less porn here than I would have thought.
How to Tie a Tie video, Elliot Hampton, Arcadia Bay, Chloe Elizabeth Price, Arcadia Bay, Chloe Elizabeth Price, Chloe Price, The Tempest quotes, The Tempest tickets, Blackwell Academy, Major Lucas Hampton, Illuminati Eye Meeting, Guards of Hell Book 3. He likes Chloe. poor bastard. Oh no. Let's read it.
That's not half bad.
When she left the room, it was electric, flushed wings taut with agony.
Okay.
I see her in the brick and mortar.
Dark.
Thanks for interrupting me, Chloe. In the fresh cut grass, eyes flashing bright like coins. The ferryman can't have her, I say, but the dark gods
Who
laugh.
Is it that Elliot's writing about?
Who do you think, Chloe? that moment when the sun is almost there, the sea so welcoming and warm, when pooled light smooths the nodding waves, when shapeless cold infinity conforms to one stark plane, and for a moment only, all is possible. All say yes. My heart says yes. Her eyes say yes.
Elliot is way more artistic than I thought.
They see her, but don't see her. How is that so? When all the world is negative and dark, and she cries out, a screaming rocket, trailing fire.
Wait, are these about me? What the fuck, Elliot?
What does that say? You are about to die? Well, fuck. How childish she is, how lovely and how cruel, her black knife spilling words and dripping ink. This boy's, heartbroken and in love. Yeah. Okay, we'll close it in a second.
Wow. I remember this show. Crazy that Elliot would hold on to this picture after so long.
Is it really that crazy, though? If your bitch Tori remembers correctly, Chloe held on to a picture of her and Max from, like, back in, like, 2011 or something. When it was, like, 2016. Or, like, maybe they were, like, really young pirates. Maybe they were, like, 10 years old or something. And then 8 years older, or, like, 8 years afterwards, she still had it. So, like, are you surprised, Chloe? Are you? I'm not sure you are, girl. Not sure. Let's close that, since Zoe doesn't get suspicious that we've been poking around in there finding this dark poetry of him wanting to murder us. It says, you're about to die. I'm like, oh no.
I've never been able to get Elliot to play for me. I guess he's either really good or really bad.
Honestly, if Elliot, I don't know, he's really good at school. He likes to read in his spare fucking time. And he sounds like he has intellectual conversations with Warren about movies. And he's thoughtful, and he's artistic, and he writes poetry. So I'm assuming he's probably very good at whatever that is. Yeah, I actually don't know what that is, but he's probably good at it.
I knew Elliot did well in class, but I didn't realize he was here on a full ride.
Blackwell Academy, the future needs excellent. Elliot, blah, blah, blah. Dear Elliot, I am happy to inform you that your academic performance and financial aid status have been more than met the requirements to receive continued aid for the upcoming 2010 spring semester. The Prescott Foundation will cover all educational expenses as well as room and board. Congratulations on your continued academic success. Which begs the question, where is Elliot now? Does Elliot die? Elliot's probably dead. Because he wasn't in, 2015
kind of
Blackwell.
Preppy, oh, in his own way. Maybe he does belong at Blackwell.
He might have graduated. Because that was 2010. The school's like, what, 4 years? Yeah, he would have like graduated the year before Max, right? Like, I mean, that makes sense to me. Okay, I mean, these timelines, like, you guys have explained it to me, but I'm still like a little bit confused sometimes. I swear to God, this game was like 2013, but that says 2010. So now I'm doubting everything. Just fine. Showers. Should we go this way? Should we go this way? This way looks shorter, so let's start here first. Oh, wow, would you look at that? Oh, nothing. How fun. Okay. I guess they don't want us to go into the boys' bathroom. Encourage such things. Break a leg tonight. Can't wait to see the show. You're gonna do great. Good luck tonight, Hayden. Forgot who Hayden is.
I wanna say that half the fun of weed is knowing it's illegal, but I think it'd be just as awesome over the counter.
The Blackwell Academy Board of Trustees would like to formally remind its community that though the legalization of marijuana is currently being considered at the state level, the use of marijuana products remains illegal at both the state and federal levels. Prosecution of marijuana use or possession on Blackwell's campus will be strictly enforced. Yeah, strictly. Clearly. I wonder how we got away with it for so long. Good luck at state. Mondo. I probably read that wrong. Trevor. Oh, that's Justin. Yeah, those are our boys. Yep.
Yep. Definitely Drew's room.
You're a beast. Need to talk to you, Zach. Great game. Knock first, I guess. Open. It's all sunny in here. Okay. All right. Let's get in and grab what we need and get the fuck out and book it.
Drew's not here. Okay.
I say that, but let's explore everything instead.
Where would I hide my money? Holy shit, Drew. A college scholarship?
Oregon State!
No wonder you're so into football.
I actually really liked Oregon State when I toured it and stuff. 2009. I'm so confused what year it is right now, then. Oh my goodness. Dear Andrew, it is my great pleasure to award you a full athletic scholarship. Holy shit. To play football at Oregon State University. We know that a young man of your skills and character would make a great addition to the OSU franchise, a football dynasty that's produced NFL talent for decades. Oh my goodness. 97103. I even recognize, like, the area code of Arcadia Bay. Or, like, I don't recognize it, but I'm familiar with it because, like, my address in Portland was, like, 97213. And for some reason, it's so cool when, like, a game or, like, a book or a movie, whatever, acknowledges, like, places that you've been or, like, are very similar, like, Oregon State. Like, I don't know. It's just so cool to me. Because, oh, I remember one of the Percy Jackson books, the newer series, not the old series. Not the, like, the good series. The series where they start talking about the Roman gods or whatever. Like, they mentioned Phoenix, and I think they mentioned, like, Arizona State University or something. Anyway, they mentioned Phoenix, and I was like, holy shit, I've been there. It's just, like, so cool when you see that in, like, a book or a movie or game. Like, I don't know. I love it so much.
I didn't realize Drew was this good at sports. I bet he can't wait to get out of Arcadia Bay.
He's probably gonna die before he can leave. It's just kind of the way things work in this world. Wait, is that University of Oregon, not Oregon State? Okay, dear Andrew, congratulations. Love your incredible achievements as a high school football player and student. I'm pleased to extend an official scholarship offer to you. A University of Oregon degree is one of the most prestigious academic institutions in the Pacific Northwest. We truly feel that you are a student athlete who has potential to make a powerful impact on both our team and our student body. As the head coach, I'm here to assist and support you on your journey to success. The details of the scholarship offer are as follows. University of Washington, too? Jesus Christ, how good is he? Hello, Chris. Thank you so much for your consideration and the generous... Okay, and the generous scholarship offer. I regret to inform you that I've chosen to extend Oregon State in the fall. Thanks for your time. So we got offers coming in left and right.
Looks like Drew sells happy pills to his fellow meatheads.
If this got out that he's a dealer or a seller or distributor or whatever, like, this would jeopardize his scholarships. Quarterback candy? Hey, bro, do you have any more happy pills? I'm beat as hell. You saw me take that hit for you last night, right? No one gets in my boy's grill on my watch, but hook me up, will you? Something just take the edge off is all I need. If we get a choice somewhere in the line to expose Drew or let... I will not expose Drew. I will let him fuck up on someone else's timeline, not mine. He can fuck up with us, but I'm not going to let him fuck up his future. Although, I mean, he is probably going to die before he can get his scholarship, which would be, yeah, unfortunate. So, like, but, like, I'm not going to mess that up for him. Like, he can mess it up by himself in college if he wants to be a distributor in college. But, like, I wouldn't, like, if there's a choice, I feel like there may be a choice coming soon if we should expose Drew for his shenanigans here in high school. And I don't think I would. Like, he'll either stop or he'll continue and then he'll get caught later. But, like, I don't want to be the one to expose him because this is such an incredible opportunity. And as a person of color, like, he should have that opportunity. And I get the feeling like he's had a kind of a shitty, I don't know about this though, but, like, he might have had a shitty childhood that he's had to rise up from. I don't know. Maybe I'm guessing, or maybe I've read that somewhere. I don't know where, but, like, that's the feeling I'm getting from him for some reason, because I feel like that's everyone's backstory in Life is Strange is, like, shitty childhood, crappy situation. They have to rise above and then they die. Yeah, that's just, like, Life is Strange. I'm feeling very bitter today about, like, everything.
So many folks are shit out of luck around here. At least Drew has some prospects.
From Anthony North. Who's Anthony North? Okay. Drew, what an amazing game, son. Oh, it's his dad. Couldn't believe that third quarter conversion. You've got moves, no doubt. I spent the day at the library again. Computers aren't my thing, you know that. But I'm trying to learn. There's a remedial skills class Mikey made me promise to take, so I'm going to do that next. See about learning how to type worth a damn. Never had to type on a fishy boat. Taking me forever to finish this email. Prospects for works are rough, but you know how it is. Don't worry about your pops. Keep an eye on that damn ball, and there's nothing that'll stop you. I'm proud of you. P.S. Give Mikey a hug for me. I'll be by tomorrow afternoon to take him to the clinic. Oh, Mikey's sick. Oh, no, and they have no money. He needs a scholarship. I'm not fucking it up for him. If there's a choice, I'm not doing that to him. No, no. He'll either straighten up and fly straight, or he'll get caught.
I was really looking forward to running all those sweaty laps.
Printed name, Anthony North, signature. Waiver and release form for physical education. I think I remember how to sign one of those in my freshman year of high school.
We might have failed to kill you, Durgeron. But something tells me Mikey's not through. Yet. Bad guys don't usually look so obvious, but... this is still awesome. Awesome.
He's an artist. Poor Frank is like, what the fuck is taking Chloe so long? It's because we're... what's the word? We're sifting. We're sifting through all of Drew's shit. Okay. Jurassic Edition. I love that. That is so great. Sleeping bag. Wait, where's his fucking bed? Did he give it to his dad or something?
Looks like Mikey's been staying here with Drew.
Oh, why? Why is Mikey staying here with Drew?
Mikey's figures. Playing that game yesterday was actually fun.
Wait, so those are Mikey's pictures. Wait a second. Why are they living together?
They look so happy.
Do you know what probably happened to the mom? She probably got run over by a car. In the typical Life is Strange fashion. One parent's always dead and they probably died by a car.
Man, looks like Drew's dad is having a hard time.
There is no fucking way I'm ruining the scholarship for this boy. And if anyone else tries to, I will fight them. I will fight them.
Is the money in there?
I don't want to take his money now!
All right. No! Guess I have to crack a 4-digit code.
To crack a code? Oh no! I might just look it up because I'm literally so bad. Fuck. Has to be something important. Okay, calendar. Might be something interesting on the calendar.
I wonder exactly how important 516 is to Drew.
I don't know. If it's not that, I might just look it up. 056. Fuck. So sensitive. Just like me.
Damn it. Wrong numbers.
Okay, I'll try a few more times and then I'll look it up because I don't think I can deal with it.
Look at that. More numbers.
Which one do we like more, though? 11, 20, 36. Oh, no! That's too many numbers. Well, great. Let's see if there's anything
Holy
on the letter.
Shit, Drew. A college scholarship? No wonder you're so into football.
I don't know what the number would be, guys. I don't know. It has to be something with a football poster. For the love of the game. 11, 20, 36. Extreme football fight. No, it's not on there. Bigfoots. Okay. 09. Okay. Are you football? Are you? Overpaid. Slightly promiscuous woman. I don't know, guys. Is it like...
Hoping that Drew would make something obvious for his lock combo.
That, yeah, me too. And it probably is. I'm just picking the non-obvious thing. No, please. No, please. I hate it when it does that.
Damn it. Wrong numbers.
What is obvious in here that I'm missing? Obvious. Something obvious. Don't overthink it. Something so obvious you're shaketh. Okay. Like... I hate these codes. Let's do 1120. I don't know. That literally makes no sense to me if it's 1120. It has to be more complicated than that.
Damn it. Wrong numbers.
Okay, it's not 1120. 2036, maybe? 2036. 2036. 20. Oh my god, why? Seriously, like, I'm not even doing anything. And, like, it literally just does automatically when I switch.
Damn it. Wrong numbers.
1136, maybe? That's the last one I'm trying, and then I'm looking it up, because I cannot. Wait, what was it? 1136? Shit, what did I say? I don't know. Ah! I think it might have been...
Might actually need some help with this one.
Mikey. 1227. She just like didn't even question.
1227.
1227. Yes. Wait, are you serious? That's all I had to do? I just had to try it a couple times and it would do it for me? I don't want to take the money, dude. Oh, it's so cute! It looks like Pompidou! Kind of.
Did you up, too?
I feel so sorry for Drew now. I know he's kind of a jackass. No, I don't want to do it! Put it back! No, it's probably to help his dad! No, I should have just left without having the money. Can I put it back? I can't rewind! No, I feel so bad. He's gonna be poor. His dad needs help. He needs a football scholarship. He's probably selling drugs to help his dad. That's my theory.
Out of here.
Can I put it back? Please let me put it back. Bitch, please let me put it back.
Exactly the way I found it.
He's selling drugs to help his family. Like, I'm almost positive. Even if he isn't, he must be doing it for a good reason. I don't wanna. He's gonna be right outside the door. Oh shit! Oh shit!
Hey, Elamon.
Chloe? What are you doing here?
Looking for Drew.
I was looking for your brother, but he's not here, so.
Why?
Bro.
Or. Fuck, he's right there. I knew it. I fucking knew it. Or. Drew is selling drugs to help with his brother's medical bills. Because remember, the dad's like, I'll take Mikey to the clinic tomorrow. I'm like, Mikey probably has cancer and is going to die. He's selling drugs to help his family, whatever capacity that may be in. I feel so bad. I shouldn't have opened it, but I didn't have a choice, you see? Like, so responsibility is off of me, but I didn't have a choice. I just tried it a certain amount of times, which was lucky in of itself. And then Steph just gave me the fucking number and the answer. Like, nah. We're so fucked. We're so fucked right now.
Yesterday wasn't enough? You want to go another round? Doesn't matter. Mikey, get your stuff. Let's move.
He's not going to question why we're in his room.
Relax. Slow down.
What? Wait, who's that hoe?
Shit.
You're making me think you're nervous about something.
Who the hell is that?
No one. Stay in here and don't say anything, little brother. Whatever you do, don't open the door.
No. Is he gonna get beat up? He's gonna die right now, isn't he? He's gonna get shot.
Damon, you shouldn't have come here. School's not the place for this.
Really? Where is the place to collect my fucking money?
Shut.
I told you, I don't have it. Sales are down, man. Nobody wants to get high right now. But look, it's spring season. We just started 2-a-days. Those are gonna kill us. I'll be able to sell all the oxy you've got.
Drew, you owe me a grand. Where is it?
I said I don't have it right now. I heard about your dad's job, by the way. Tough time. Yeah. Bet a grand would mean a lot to him right now.
Fuck.
Where's my money, Drew?
I don't know what you expect me to do. I can't just make money appear out of thin air.
I want my fucking money!
You don't have to hit me, man. I'm gonna...
Where is...
We should go out there before someone gets shot.
Just give me 1 week.
You're just going to lie there?
I thought football players were supposed to be tough.
No.
I'm sorry to have to do this, kid. No one steals from me.
We need to intervene. We're intervening! Fuck. Damon the money.
Stop! It's okay. I've got your money.
Ah, I didn't realize we had an audience. Hey, Mikey. Okay. Who the hell are you?
Frank sent me to collect.
That's what Frank was going on about? Let's see the cash.
We need that!
Oh, maybe I shouldn't have. Oh, I regret everything!
It's all here. Mikey, you need to help your big brother. Help him understand that I take this shit seriously.
Come on! Mikey's got nothing to do with this, man.
You help your brother understand that if he steals from me again, I'm coming back here and I'm going to break his knees. Thanks, kid. Tell Frank I owe him one.
I thought it was supposed to be for Frank's money. Like, I thought it was, we're getting it for Frank, but Frank was getting it for his friend?
You just screwed us over.
Are you crazy? That guy could have killed you.
Oh, I feel so conflicted.
You don't know anything about this situation. It's none of your
business. I feel so conflicted. No!
Yes, it is. Mikey's my friend. I don't want him to get hurt.
You think you're some kind of hero? Stepping in for poor Nathan Prescott? And now you're messing with our lives? Mikey, I gotta look at your arm. Just leave us alone.
Oh, I have so many regrets. Maybe I should... Oh, I probably should have just... stayed with Mikey. But like, what if Drew had died because of my choice? I would have felt so bad. I'm sorry. Look, I'm so sorry. Please forgive me.
I'm sorry.
Sorry doesn't get our dad off the streets, does it?
But it means you're safe, though. I'll take it. I'll take the decision. Okay. Their dad is what? 30, 40? They're like, what? 15? 16, 18, he's probably like 35, 40, right? If he has to live his life on the streets because of the decision I made, like, I think that's fine for me. I'm not fine, but like, these kids, they have so much more of their lives to live. This sounds so bad. It was not even my business to get fucking interfered in the first place. But since it happened, I think that was the better decision because Mikey and Drew could have been severely injured or died. And Mikey is already having to go to the clinic and stuff because he probably has cancer or something horrible. So, like, two people who have the rest of their lives to live out versus one person who has another 50 years, where they have like 70 maybe, like, I guess I'm trying to justify it when there's actually no justification, but it makes me feel a little bit better, so like, don't get angry with me, because it actually makes me feel better when I think about it that way. God. Oh no. Oh, you guys are right. It picked up real quick. I can't snap, but like, I tried. Real quick. See that shit? Real quick. I can't snap. I'm so bad at snapping. Oh, that one was better. Caleb can snap really loud. I cannot. It's pathetic. Oh, are we watching The Tempest? God, I hope we're watching The Tempest right now. Oh, those look like production lights. Oh, I think we're gonna watch The Tempest. The clouds look really good. Oh wait, those aren't clouds. That's from the forest fire. Whoopsies. Oh no. I guess we're either super early, like way too early, or it's gonna happen like tomorrow, not today. Looks so pretty.
This day has been so messed up. At least I can talk to Rachel now. If I can find her back.
Oh, we have to read that, don't we? Oh no. Chloe, it's Steph. I'm on my way to the hospital. Mikey's arm is broken. Drew told me a little bit about what happened. Shit, I didn't know it was that bad. The situation is so fucked up. Let me know if there's any way I can help. Thinks I will. Oh no, now we have hospital bills. Oh no. Maybe I didn't make the right choice. I don't know. I don't think I made... We've seen that before. Fuck. I regret everything. I have so many regrets. But also, I don't know if I made the right choice or not.
I've already seen what happens when Rachel plays with fire. Rachel plus swords should be fun.
Not fun. Catastrophic. Try that. Play, I wanna play.
Chloe Price presents Firewalk. Laser Light Spectacular.
She's so cute. I miss her blue hair. I really do. Okay, we'll talk to Mr. What's-His-Name in a second.
No way in hell I'm going up on that stage.
Okay. Alright, okay. Alright, okay. Alright, okay. How's your super long errand going? Yo, crazy shit happened in Drew's room, like really bad. Oh no, are you okay? Do you need to talk about it? Yeah, later. Don't worry, until the show's over. I'm backstage. Great, on my way.
Did Doug dig David's garden, or did David dig Doug's?
After all the work Steph did, it's amazing that she would drop everything to be there for Mikey.
They're friends. That's what friends do.
Sports just look so... exhausting.
Ha, same. I need to start exercising more.
You'd think having a jock for a brother would protect you from getting hurt. Man, I hope Mikey's okay.
Well, Mikey's not gonna die now. Probably.
See, another reason to be thankful for my recent life change.
Who's this hoe?
Hey, Samantha.
Shh.
Nathan, please.
I can't do it, Dad. I'm sorry.
Keep your voice down. Now listen to me.
Listen.
You don't understand. They all hate me. They're just gonna laugh at me.
Why do you suppose that is?
That's
I don't
so
know,
mean.
Because you show weakness. Just like you're doing right now.
Dad!
When will you learn that this isn't about you and your problems? This is about the Prescott name. My name. You will not embarrass me. Nathan.
Our child!
Yes.
Don't abuse our child!
Now. Break a leg. I'll see you after the show.
Great pep talk, Mr. P. Everyone knows the best way to instill confidence in someone is by intimidating them.
I don't know who you are, but mind your own business.
Fuck
I'd
you. Fuck you, you Mr. Prescott.
Like, a private bunker filled with gold coins where you could have these
conversations? Bunker? No, bunker? No, poor choice of words. Oh, God. He's gonna be so pissed at us right now. I don't give a shit. He looks terrifying, but also really sad.
Fuck!
I'm so glad we did it, even though it pisses him off. I'm so glad we did it. Actually, it might make his situation worse, but like, fuck, I don't know. I feel so conflicted.
R.A. will suck as Prospera.
If Rachel
VC
Amber.
If she had any talent, maybe she would have gotten the part.
Talent? Is that what got Mr. K to cast you, slut?
Guess they don't call it drama for nothing. Hey. Nathan's dad is some asshole, huh?
I know. I wish he'd just go away and leave him alone.
Nathan's dad sucks. But you should be careful what you wish for when it comes to parents.
Oh, Chloe. I wasn't thinking. I'm sorry.
For what? You didn't kill my dad. Or did you? That was a joke.
I know. Your dark sense of humor reminds me a lot of Nathan's. Actually, the two of you are really similar.
What the hell does that mean?
I'm serious. You're both artistic and surprisingly sensitive. You've been through a lot, and a lot of people unfairly judge you for it. I think you stood up for Nathan yesterday because you know what he's going through. Nathan's hurt, and he needs help. But whenever I try to help him, it always seems to make things worse. If you were Nathan right now, what would you want me to do?
It hurts so much, our baby Nathan. Oh, the pain. Give him help.
When I'm super pissed, the last thing I want is someone trying to calm me down. But maybe it's what I need. Nathan acted like he didn't want our help yesterday. But trust me, he was glad we did.
Wow. Thanks, Chloe. That's actually super helpful. Thanks for your help, Chloe. Here's hoping.
Okay, we can go in there in a second. Hayden, let's talk to you.
Hey, Hayden.
I forgot who you are.
Address me as Ferdinand, good lady.
Go fuck yourself.
All right, hey, Ferdinand.
Sup, Chloe. I mean, sup, fair maiden.
Sup, fair maiden.
Method acting.
Really? Thanks.
She's being facetious, yo. She's being facetious. All right, let's talk to Mr. Keaton over here.
Sup, Mr. Keaton.
Why, if it isn't the muse of the Blackwell Drama Department.
Tell me, young lady, do you still believe true love exists?
Yes.
Sure, I think so. But it's a lot weirder and scarier than poets and pop songs make it out to be.
You might be surprised, my dear. Budding dramaturge, may your propitious appearance counteract the tragedy of Stephanie Gingrich's sudden recusal. An emergency, she says.
Ward.
Stephanie was our lion of the light board, but platitudinal though it may be, the show must sojourn forth.
That dude is weird.
That's when you know he makes a great drama teacher. All right, let's go in the tent.
Rachel?
Oh shit, we forgot to talk to Dana! Fuck! No, go back! No, shit. God damn it. I forgot to talk to Dana. She probably had something interesting to say. I'll have to look it up. Someone tell me what Dana said. Hopefully it wasn't important. I feel like the Nathan thing was definitely important. I should be more careful. What is this bitch doing? She's gonna make Rachel sick right before the performance. Mm-hmm.
Whatever that was, it was shady as shit.
Victoria.
I need to find whatever Victoria slipped into that drink.
Let's just dump out the tea first.
Muscle relaxers?
Fuck! No, that's so bad. Dump out the tea, just fucking dump it.
Or your tea gets... What are you doing here? This area is for cast and crew only. Or are you only here to try and sabotage the play like you sabotaged my homework? God, you're pathetic.
I'm here to support Rachel.
How nice.
I want to make sure she's relaxed before the show.
Whatever.
Whatever.
Oh, Rachel Amber. It was customary among the thespians of ancient Greece for the understudy to offer hot tea to the lead actress on opening night, as a way of showing appreciation for her tutelage. It is in that spirit that I offer you this beverage. May it help to reveal the essence of your talents for all to see.
Wow. That, thanks.
Just tell Rachel.
Bitch, dosed your tea.
Excuse me? How dare you?
Victoria, could this possibly be true?
Victoria.
Of course not.
Could this possibly be true?
Dropout Chloe is clearly directing her misplaced anger at me. I'm sorry your life is a mess, but it's not my fault, okay?
Chloe, Victoria is my friend. She would never do anything to sabotage me.
She should drink the tea.
She should prove it. Drink the tea.
What?
I wouldn't dare insult Victoria's integrity like that. Then again...
Drink the fucking tea!
That's what it'll take to convince you that Victoria is a good and caring person. Fine. Come on, Vic. Put... drop out Chloe in her place once and for all.
Do people not realize that you can fake taking a sip of something? They didn't ask her to drink the entire cup of tea. They asked her to, like, drink it, like, maybe, like, a sip. So, like, all you have to do, you take, there's fucking, pretend there's fucking water in this, right? Like, it's, why does no one ever think of this? Like, if there's poison or whatever, you think you're gonna get poisoned, like, fucking President Snow? Instead of President Snow, just, like, drinking the fucking wine or whatever that was poisoned, just, like, do it. Let the substance touch you. Puff out your cheeks a little to make it look like you have something in there. Not like enormously, not like, but like a little more than usual, and then swallow. Like, let it touch so you can see the liquid like almost entering, but it's not entering, it's not penetrating your mouth. I can't talk about this. This is so, I'm not describing this well, but like, do you get me? Does like no one else think about this? Because this has come up multiple times in books and movies and apparently games too, and like no one ever thinks to just like, that looks fucking realistic. Like, it looks exactly the same as someone taking a sip, because the water or like the drink or substance or whatever is literally rushing towards it, like, and it's coating like your face, but you don't have to ingest it. Like, I don't, I'm over it. I cannot. Oh my goodness.
Oh, happy? So happy.
Ugh, whatever. If you're done accusing me of things, I'll just be on my way. Bitches.
Wow. Saved my ass again, Price.
All in a day's work. And this has been a particularly batshit crazy day.
Sweet Tarnations, we're ruined. The show is ruined.
Sweet Tarnations, what in Tarnation?
My dear poor young guy. Artists, a misfortune most unkind has befallen us. Juliet is waylaid. That infernal inferno is the culprit, closing down the roads and robbing us of our Ariel. Would that she could manifest on her master's whim as a true spirit. Alas, devoid of an understudy, the situation is a dire one indeed.
That's just so funny to me. Alas! Wait, let's try it again. Alas! I want to see if I can actually get rid of my headphones by doing that. Hold up. Alas! Oh, shit. I'm so sorry. This is not what you signed up for when you were clicking on this video. What am I doing?
I'm afraid we may have to cancel.
You didn't have an understudy
truly
for that, bitch?
A cursed lot. Even my prodigious imagination cannot conceive of a worse turn of fate.
Muscle relaxers. Touché.
What? Oh, no.
Mr. Keaton.
No.
Chloe could step in for Juliet.
No fucking chance.
At least until the road's clear.
The romantic.
She's the right fit for Juliet's costume.
She is indeed. Tell me, my dear, have
this
you
is a
ever
twist
acted before?
I have never expected.
Hell no.
She's being modest. We play improv games all the time. And she's fantastic at it.
My dear, what if I told you that the entire fate of the production rests upon your slender shoulders?
Victoria's over there fucking twitchy.
Chloe, please.
She's just like twitching over there. Fuck Victoria. What a bitch.
Damn it.
That's fucking... I
can't believe Rachel's talked me into this.
I've never felt so fulfilled playing a game before. I feel so fucking great right now. Look at this shit. She actually looks really pretty. She's wearing makeup. Ooh, I mean, she looks really pretty without makeup, but look how cool she looks. That's such a cool costume. I would totally be that for Halloween. Like, I think that's next year's Halloween costume, guys. Only, like, a handful of you would get it, either. Like, it's very obscure, actually. Here's the mirror. Don't we look fantastic? Oh, look! We look so cute! Oh, look at us! Guys, we look so adorable.
I seriously have to memorize all of this? Thanks, Rachel.
It's a lot. Oh no. I mean, it's not that much, but it's like enough that it's like, do you know what I want to see happen? I hope that when they're playing, like when the play starts, like she takes all of this, but she makes it into Chloe language. So she's going to say, everybody, mistress, I'm here to serve you. Or she like just puts it in like her Chloe vocabulary instead of saying, all hail great mistress, I come to answer thy best pleasures. She says, I'm here for you. Like something like that. Or like, I boarded the king's ship in every cabin. I flamed amazement. The fire and cracks of sulfurs roaring the most mighty Neptune seemed to besiege and make his bold waves tremble. I went on the king's ship. There was fire. Neptune is scared. Wait, let's keep doing it. Okay. Not a soul, the king's son, Ferdinand, was the first man that leaped, cried, hell is empty, and all the devils are here. There was no one. Ferdinand was the first dude who's like, shit, everything is empty and we're gonna die. Actually, don't know. Shakespeare. I didn't ever like The Tempest, actually. Not a hair perished, and as thou batst me, I've dispersed them about the isle in troops. No one died. I have hidden them around this place. I don't know. Is there more toil? Let me remember thee what thou hast promised. Do we have to do more work? Let me remind you what you promised me, bitch. My liberty. I don't think I even need to, like, paraphrase that. That's my noble mistress. That's my friend, you ho. Ariel exits. And you're done. I like Rachel's cute little notes in that. Climb to top of shipwreck. The notes are so cute. You're cute. Oh, that's actually, like, not even, like, that big of a deal. We could make that work.
Why does it feel like Steph is mocking me from afar?
See me or Mr. K for makeup kits. Steph. Okay. Let's... Oh, wait. Oh...
It wouldn't be called a makeup mirror if it wasn't supposed to have makeup all over it.
Graffiti! We're graffitiing it!
Use it to tag shit.
She looks so cute in that outfit. Look at her. Like, she looks adorable. Let's do a tragedy. I don't want to focus more on death than we have to, I think. Seriously, look how cute she is in the sparkles. I love this. Max is quaking. Alright. I think there was something from Elliot. Chloe, the show's starting. We got great seats. Where are you? Oh, you'll see. What? Oh, guys, this is gonna be so fun and so exciting.
The only thing worse than looking at spandex is being forced to wear it.
Spider-Man's been a lot on my mind lately, and do you remember, I don't know how many of you guys have seen the really crappy, amazing Spider-Mans, but in the first one of my favorite scenes is just, he's like, scrolling through Bing, who the fuck uses Bing anyway, but like, he's scrolling through Bing, and he's just like, trying to get like, costume ideas for his costume or whatever, and he's just like, spandex, spandex, so much spandex, or something like that, and it was just the best ever.
Looks like I'm late. As usual.
Me. I'm so sorry to everyone in my life. I'm always like, oh, look at these cute little drawings. Ariel. Prospera. Miranda. Those are such cute costumes. Oh, wait, do I want to leave? Okay, let's make sure we got everything before we leave. I suspect there's nothing in there, I guess. Okay. Okay, we got the script. This is a mirror. It's not a, not an entrance. I don't know why I keep thinking that. Oh wait, what's the difference between leaving here and leaving over here?
Are you choking?
No.
Time for my big day.
What?
We can hear you like joy. Screaming or something.
I'm not choking.
Well, you're a dinosaur or what?
I don't know.
Okay.
Were you concerned?
Yeah.
Over my life? Get out. Apparently, they think I'm dying. That's not what I sound like! Oh my god! Stop! Oh my goodness! Sounds like a clicker and a raptor mixed together.
Most strange, bountiful fortune hath mine enemies brought to this shore. Here, cease more questions. Thou art inclined to sleep. Tis a good dullness, and give it way. I know thou canst not choose. Come away, servant. Come.
Ah, shit. I'm on.
Ah, shit.
I am ready now.
Get up there.
Approach, my Ariel. Come.
Damn it.
Look how unhappy she looks.
I've got this. I just walk to Rachel and say my line.
Oh, walk to Rachel, but I kind of want to stand up here. Oh, are we... This is the middle of a performance. We can explore things in the middle of a fucking performance.
I'm definitely supposed to do something with this.
Oh, fuck.
I want to play her part.
I love this so much.
Ugh, that killed my eyes.
I love this so much. This is hilarious. She looks so... Oh, there's people. Oh, shit. I'm getting scared.
Hey, I sat here yesterday.
This is not the time for this, I say as we continue pressing on things.
I wish I could throw that at Rachel for getting me into this.
All right, let's talk to Rachel, shall we? Fuck, I should have paid more attention to that script.
All hail, great mistress. I come to answer thy best pleasure.
Most fearless, generous spirit. Hast thou performed to point the tempest that I bade thee?
I boarded the king's ship. In every cabin, I flamed amazement. The fire and...
I want to make this performance a success, but I also want to see what happens if I just completely botch it and do the Chloe language that I kind of predicted would happen. I didn't know it would give us the option to do it. So, I don't know what to do, guys. I really don't know what to do.
Roaring, the
what do you want? I'm not screeching.
I know, so that was Brendan. I thought it was you. He just now told me, so. Sorry.
It wasn't even me? No. You thought I was dying?
It was Brendan.
Get out. I love you.
I love you too.
Ho.
To besiege and make his bold waves... tremble.
Bold waves!
My brave spirit.
Bold waves!
So firm, so constant, that this coil would not infect his reason.
Not a soul. The king's son, Ferdinand... was the first man that leaped from his ship and cried, hell is empty and all the devils are here.
Yes.
Oh, he looks so happy.
Safe?
All right. I guess this is when I'm supposed to walk somewhere. Not a hair perished. And,
not a hair perished.
I have dispersed them about the isle.
Fuck. Chloe, stand here. That little note is adorable. In... troops?
In... troops!
Bravo!
Ariel, was it right?
Thy charge exactly is performed. But there's...
Yay! More
is
lines.
There more toil? Let me remember thee what thou hast promised.
How now? What is't thou canst demand?
Liberty, right?
My liberty.
Indeed.
Thy liberty?
Nay, this most of all I will not grant. That's not her line, is it? What's going on? But thou assured my freedom, didn't thou? I never said how dearly I hold thee. My habit's been to keep my soul well draped. Most loyal spirit, companion, and friend, is acting in my service not replete with excitement, amusement, and delight?
Of course, mistress. Most truly, it is so.
Mr. Key, they're way off script.
It's magical.
Then why?
It's magical!
Wish you to be free.
Excitement's a mere counterfeit of bliss. These storms and these adventures. I prefer to know thou still cared for my plainest self.
I have thee in my grasp. I will not bend.
She has such a cool voice.
I will not see thee flying forth alone. The envy would be more than I could bear.
So come with me.
So come with me. Is that not in thy power?
Spirit, take my hands. Most faithful friend, for but a little longer I beseech. Continue in thy service to my schemes, and when they are complete, I swear to thee, we shall fly beyond this isle. The corners of the world are mere prologue. I'll seek to make thy happiness so great that e'en the name of liberty is forgot. What sayest thou to my most hopeful wish?
Say yes!
Yes. I am most pleased.
Your duty done for now, so go forth hence with haste.
I've work to do.
You crushed it. So good.
You're a born thespian, my dear.
Aww.
I'll be chasing you down next year. And the ending, absolutely transformative.
Wait, okay. Before we go further, I need to see what should have happened. I need to know. Tempest? Because, like, what if Nathan didn't get to do his part because of what we just did? So, Tempest? Summary? Like, I don't fucking know. Tempest summary, spark notes, schmoop. Give me fucking Wikipedia. I need something short and sweet. Okay, fuck. Story. How long is this story? Oh, that is, that's real long. After discharging this task, Ariel will finally be free. Prospero pardons Caliban, who is sent to Prospero. Ariel is charged the king's Ariel is charged to prepare the proper sailing weather to guide the ship, the king's ship, back to the royal fleet and then to Naples, where Ferdinand and Miranda will be married. Prospero was Rachel, right? Fuck, I don't know. Someone tell me in the comments. The Wikipedia plot summary is way too long and I don't remember who characters are what, so I just know that Chloe was Ariel. I'm pretty sure Rachel was Prosper, but I'm not entirely sure, and I'm pretty sure we just fucked up Nathan's part, so now he can be even more hated by his father, so that's great.
I am humbled.
Thanks.
What the hell just happened?
Strangeness of
was that real?
Put heaviness in me.
Shake it off. Come on. We'll visit Caliban, my slave.
Tis a villain, sir. I do not love to look on.
He does make our fire, fetch in our wood. What ho! Slave!
What ho?
Caliban,
what ho?
Come forth, I say.
As wicked
well, that's Caliban.
As e'er my mother brushed with raven's feather from unwholesome fen, drop on you both. A southwest blow on ye, and blister you all o'er.
Thou poisonous slave, got by the devil himself. Filth as thou art, I have lodged thee in mine own cell, till thou didst seek to violate the honor of my child.
Oh ho, oh ho! Would it had been done?
Oh,
thou
ho.
Didst prevent me? I had peopled else this isle with Calibans.
Fetch us in fuel, and be quick. So, slave, hence.
Where should
I'm so fucking lost.
Be? In the air or the earth?
This play is super.
It's Shakespeare. It's Shakespeare. It's always going to be intense.
A spirit? It carries a brave form, but it is a spirit.
No, wench. It eats and sleeps and hath such senses as we have.
I will resist such entertainment.
Put thy sword up, traitor.
Do you love me?
O heaven, O earth, bear witness to this sound. I, beyond all limit of what else in the world, do love, prize, honor you.
His tears run down his beard like winter's drops from eaves of reeds.
Go release them, Ariel. My charms I'll break. Their senses I'll restore, and they shall be themselves.
I wish I had done Midsummer Night's Dream, but
now
I mean, this was
okay.
Now my charms
are all overthrown. And what
Now that I think of it, so our school, sorry, but our school had something called, we had a field trip and we'd go to the Utah Shakespeare Festival. It's my favorite festival ever. But anyway, I'm pretty sure The Tempest was playing one night, and I actually fell asleep through it because it was so boring to my eyeballs. Most Shakespeare's, like, I can get through, except the Henry the Fifths, I think. Or any of the Henrys, I'll just fucking die. Like, I don't think I can watch any of the Henrys. But, like, Tempest, I don't think I've ever liked it. Or maybe it's just because I fell asleep through that one time. I don't know. Maybe I kind of want to watch it now. Who's up for a Tempest movie night? I am,
Frank,
kind of.
I have mine own. Pray, release me from my bands with the help of your good hands.
This is enchanting. This is absolutely magical. Magical! So it's gonna be like my thing from now on. I just love it. Nathan did so well. I'm so proud of our child. She looks so cute in face paint. Oh my goodness, I love her.
Wasn't that fun?
You're so dead.
Yeah? How dead?
Hella dead.
They'd be seriously the cutest. Hella dead. Hella dead. Ah! That is such a cute costume. Seriously adorable. Oh, what is this bitch looking so upset about? Huh. Very interesting. Very, very interesting. Oh, crap. I think we can finish it in this episode. We're already an hour and 8 minutes. How much do we have left? Oh, no!
Oh, my God! Keaton's face behind you when you walked on stage? I was shitting myself.
So cute. Oh, I love it. Oh!
He was shitting himself.
That dude owes me.
Like a dream come true, I'll take you where I roam. And follow you back home.
This entire episode in of itself has redeemed Life is Strange Before the Storm for me.
What if I told you that the entire fate of our production rests upon your slender shoulders?
Alas! I love that so much, I don't even know why.
I've never had an experience like that on stage. Yeah, right? You were... No, you. Like, seriously. I love nights after a show. Is it always like this? Oh, totally. It's such a high. No more nerves, just the adrenaline. So, first timer, are you proud of yourself? You were literally perfect tonight. I was blown away. I think I'm just happy it's over. The last 12 hours have been freaking intense.
You've gone through so much shit today.
Right now's pretty good. Okay, the whole show was good. I admit it.
Yeah. It was magical.
Hold her hand. Aww. Aww. So cute.
Let's leave. For real.
For real.
You said you wanted to skip town and never look back. Like I said last night, let's do it.
I know. I've been thinking about that all day.
But that was...
Don't say it was just a crazy thought. You mean it. I can tell. You want this.
Yeah, but, like, eventually.
Let's go now. Didn't we already agree on stage?
We can't just...
Why not?
Okay, fine, you win.
Fine then, drama queen. Where are we going?
You tell me. What uniquely twisted location does Chloe Price plus Rachel Amber equal?
I know Los Angeles is where they kind of decided, but I don't want to just keep making choices based on what I know is already going to happen. I think them having a road trip would be awesome.
I'm feeling like an indefinitely long road trip.
That sounds like the greatest idea anyone's ever thought of. You and me driving down the coast, filling up our truck with hilarious souvenirs, and every night... We'll find a different beach to walk along and watch the sun go down. And one day, you'll be at a gas station fixing the brakes, and some guy with no shirt on will come up.
No.
Okay.
He'll be like, "That's so hot that you know about cars." And I'll say, "Back off. She's with me."
You're full of shit.
I love this.
I love this time of night. Don't you just... feel like everything's possible?
Oh, she's so full of life.
Stop.
Don't ruin it! Don't ruin it!
It's just making me feel like shit that this life you're describing isn't going to happen.
For fuck's sake! I've never been more serious in my life.
Kiss, please kiss.
Chloe, what would it take to convince you?
Do we have it? Oh! Kiss!
How about, Oh.
Is that convincing enough?
Yeah.
my god, yes! 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 Oh, they are so cute together!
Holy shit.
My god!
Right?
What is this stuff?
It's snow. So magical. This is so magical!
It's a sign. I think we should leave tonight.
You should leave tonight, because then you can avoid death.
Mm-hmm. You want to. I'm ready.
Leave tonight. Please leave tonight.
Stuff from my house.
And we're gonna get caught. No, we're leaving tonight. We're getting a happy ending. We're getting that happy ending. I need that.
That sounds perfect.
It's all gonna turn to shit. No, please, no. Just happy ending. Just, I need it, please. Wait, what are you doing? Don't. What are you doing, Chloe? Chloe? Okay. Okay, girl. I was worried. I was worried for a second. I really was. Crap, guys, I don't know how much we have left. It's getting really long, too. I guess we'll just finish it.
Oh, you're home.
Oh, no.
Rose, Rachel's home. And she, brought her new friend.
Our star returns. You're just in time. Dinner's almost ready. Chloe, was it?
What is the difference between these two answers?
Nailed it. I must have been pretty memorable.
You were. I get the sense that you're used to making an impression.
Rachel, honey, you were resplendent tonight.
Thanks.
Chloe, you must join us for dinner tonight.
She must? I must?
Of course.
I made chicken a la king. I'm sure you both acted up quite the appetite.
There's no option. I hate these lack of options. They're basically the same thing.
Thanks. But I was just gonna stop in for a sec and then bounce.
Oh, did you have other dinner plans?
Dinner plans? I always thought dinner was something that just sort of happens.
Chloe, I know we didn't exactly meet each other at our best this morning, but with you and Rachel becoming such fast friends, I insist you join us for dinner. Don't you agree, Rachel?
Yes, of course, Chloe. Would you join us for dinner, please? Of course.
So formal.
Great. I just need to wash off. Then I'll be right down.
Don't be long. In meantime, perhaps you can help me with the table, Chloe?
Sure.
Oh, we don't need to wash up either? Okay. All right. Guess we don't need to be clean.
I'm gonna go pack. After dinner, we can make our break. You cool down here?
She's impulsive. Totally.
Totally. Your parents love me. They're good at coming off that way, but don't let your guard down.
Ooh.
And
Chloe,
we just need to make it through dinner. Try not to say anything that, you know,
that I would normally say.
Exactly.
They were very insistent.
Some quality time with the Ambers. What could possibly go wrong?
Everything. Everything could possibly go wrong. Price, you did the right thing. Oh, that makes me feel so shitty. I'm glad Frank's happy, though. Long term, I know Frank more. Not that makes it any better, but I feel more emotionally attached to Frank, and the fact that he approves, although isn't necessarily a good thing, isn't necessarily a bad thing either.
Rachel really was an overachiever before she met me. Glad I nipped that in the bud.
My nose is so itchy. Sorry. I don't want to speak to him yet. Let's use the computer.
It's bad enough without having to read about it afterwards. Hope Mikey's okay, though.
Armand, congrats to the wonderful cast and crew of The Tempest. So sorry I missed out, guys. Emergency came up. Love you guys. I'm so sorry. I'm sorry you don't control the fire, or do you? Chloe held it down like a champ. Hey, Stephanie, need to update on Mikey recovering. This isn't the place to discuss. Text me if you want to talk.
How to clear browser history, followed by a gap for all of yesterday. That's like cheating asshat 101. Poor Rachel.
40 plus healthy lifestyle, the beacon, Arcadia Bay, golf sale, incognito tab, how to clear browser history. Oh God. Oh no, we can use that. Oh no.
They say all news is local, but damn.
Largest fire in Arcadia history frightens residents and baffles authorities. Fuck.
Holy shit. That's the guy who attacked Drew. I'm glad.
Oh, Damon!
The cash.
I didn't realize that. Damon is the kid. Is not the kid. That's Frank's friend that we saw in the emails. I don't know why I didn't put that together before. The mill, converted lumber mill, club north of town, larceny, extortion, distribution, assault, robbery, murder. He's having an affair with a known associate. Her name's Sarah Gearhard. Peter Giuseppe, Sheldon Pike, Francis Bowers. Francis? His name's Francis. Oh, Francis is French, and that's why he named his dog a French name, Pompidou, because he's French. I like that we call him Frank. His name's Francis. That's awesome. Rodney Thunder Sears. Ah, murder. Great. So the dad's having an affair with an associate of a suspect. That breaks so many fucking rules. I mean, love is love, but like, bad.
Some families actually go to Paris instead of just talk about it their whole lives.
Oh, Chloe wants to. Oh, that makes me so sad.
Easy to see who wears the literary pants around here.
Metamorphoses, books, Legal Digest. Wuthering Heights, The Divine Comedy doesn't actually feel like a comedy at all. Dante isn't that funny, guys. That's just my opinion, though. Okay, we could set the table.
Everything about this house is nicer, cleaner, better, and more expensive than mine. Which...
Oh, I think that's an original Who Gives a Shit.
This girl.
Damn. Wonder if this is a family heirloom.
This is a really late dinner. It's almost like 11. Crap. Let's steal something.
Glasses. Damn. The Ambers are fancy as shit.
Fancy on the outside.
Never realized that getting drunk could be so complicated. Something about this photo doesn't seem right. I should fix it.
I should fix it.
Can't tag this while Rachel's mom is right there. She totally busted
her back is turned. Her back is literally turned. They're just okay with me like snooping around their house. I'm
skeletons.
Still
lots of
love it.
Shiny dishes though.
Hey, Price, sorry about what I said earlier. You were only trying to help. Thank you, sir! No way, I'm sorry, Drew. I had no idea what to do. That was so fucked. It's okay, Mike. He's all right. I'm all right. Also, he says thanks. Tell him I said hey. Will do. In the end, I think we did what was best. Oh, shit. Tell them both I'm pulling for him. Mike is okay. Drew will text you an update in a bit. You get medals for 2 good deeds today. Everyone says the show was awesome. Oh, okay. Wait, let me go up. I heard you were in the Tempest. Yeah, I was kind of a big deal. I believe everyone says the show was awesome. You get 2 medals for 2 good deeds today. Mikey's okay. Drew will text you to update in a little bit. Oh, shit. Tell them I'm both pulling for them. Aw.
So clean. I bet Rose would kill it with my mom at the diner. Rachel and I both had great childhoods. Mine just ended a little before hers, I guess.
Solving it.
I love it. I feel like talking to her will progress the storyline. Let's talk to the dad. I actually don't know how to distract the girl, the mom, so let's speak to the dad.
Hiya, Mr. Amber.
Chloe, what can I do for you?
So, you're a district attorney. Huh?
I'm your district attorney.
So I can call you if I'm ever district arrested?
What would you be arrested for?
Whoops.
It was a joke. Not a good one, clearly. Your daughter's pretty great.
Thank you. We're fond of her as well.
You ever feel like she's so awesome at everything that you just want to shake her?
We're not doing too hot.
Me neither.
We're so awkward.
Well, what do you think? I thought Rachel was perfectly cast.
She certainly was. We're very proud of her. I had no idea they were going to do that.
Do what?
I don't know the name for it. Reverse casting? Casting a woman as a man?
Oh, I just meant the wizard part.
I suppose that's also true.
Gotta go, bye.
Duty calls. Hey, good chat, Mr. Amber.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, no. Very scary. Should we sit down? I don't know. It's a nice house. Reminds me of my house growing up. Wasn't homey. It was very... Let's make everything look good. Let's pretend we're put together. Let's pretend we're uppity and snooty and we have things. Like, I don't know. I don't really like this house. I prefer Chloe's house, honestly. Why can't I graffiti
can't
this?
Can't tag this while Rachel's mom
okay,
is right
sure.
there.
Okay, sure. Okay.
Me.
Well, I don't know how to distract this bitch, so we gotta figure something else out. I guess we'll just talk to her. Rose. It's kind of cool to be in a new environment, though.
Hey there, Mrs. Amber.
Chloe, I'm so glad you're joining us tonight.
So, you putting me to work, or what?
Yes. If you could please take 4 plates from the cupboard and set them on the table.
What if I can't?
Excuse me?
You said if I could. Never mind.
You're a riot, Chloe.
All right, Chloe. You've set the table without ruining someone's marriage before. Piece of cake.
Yes, Chloe?
How am I doing?
So, Rachel was pretty awesome tonight.
Yes, she was. Though, to be fair, she's pretty awesome every night. I wish I were half as driven when I was her age.
Me too.
I get the sense that you're a force of nature yourself. I can see why the two of you get along so well.
You can? Because it still seems crazy to me.
I don't wonder about Mr. Amber.
Integrity,
let's talk about Mr. Amber.
Honesty.
Oh, God. Loyalty. We're so bad at
what?
This.
It's on your lawn.
Oh, no.
Oh, right. Sorry. I guess I'm still getting used to being an elected official's wife.
What's it like being married to the DA?
Much like being married to anyone else, I imagine.
But with a lot more secrets, right?
Secrets? We're horrible at this. We're horrible.
Like attorney-client privilege and all that.
Well, as district attorney, he brings cases against criminals on behalf of the state. He doesn't defend them.
Of course not. So, am I crushing it?
This dinner would be taking literally minutes longer without you.
Crushing it.
I like her mom. Her mom's cute. Is there anything else we can talk to her about?
Yes, Chloe?
Yeah, what did you think of the play?
Rachel was typically amazing, but I never liked The Tempest. What did you think of
it? Same, girl, same.
To be honest, I only really read a couple pages. Theater's not really my thing. I guess I'm not so into saying words someone else came up with.
Fair point. Then again, I'm not sure you can judge the entire art form based on the dead white men your curriculum focuses on.
Damn. Shots fired, Shakespeare. So, am I crushing it?
This dinner would be taking
literally
minutes longer without you.
Crushing it.
This game is taking literal minutes longer because we're repeating dialogue. Jesus.
It's off to the table with you.
It's off to the table. Off to the table. What am I doing? Well, I guess it's just gonna be a really long-ass episode, guys. Chloe, Justin Williams' mom just called me. Were you gonna play tonight? I would have liked to see that. Kind of just happened. I know it was last minute. I'm glad you're doing well. It'd be nice to see you tonight. Are you coming home? Please, Chloe, I miss you. Aro, I guess we're just not gonna respond to that. Okay. It's fine. Wait, is that all we're supposed to do? Or are we supposed to do other things?
Yes, Chloe?
What next?
Plates? Check. Anything else?
Actually, could you be a dear and ask Mr. Amber what he'd like to drink with dinner?
I will be a dear. Talking to James. As long as I can avoid using the words cheating and scumbag, I should be fine.
Let's try. Let's try, Chloe. It's not our business to fuck up the marriage.
Something else?
What's your vice, Mr. Amber?
I'm sorry?
Your wife wants to know what kind of drink you're having.
Ah, let's
we're so bad at this.
Share.
Okay. One, two, three, sherry.
Comical. Chloe, maybe you can help me understand something.
I'll give it a shot.
Rose and I, we're worried about Rachel. Yesterday was so unlike her. What do you suppose is going on?
Oh, I think he's using his attorney skills on me to try to find out what's happening. He's, like, trying to establish trust and, like, making us feel special that we have information that he does not. Oh, fuck. I don't know what to say. Fuck, this episode's gonna be so fucking long. It's gonna take so long to upload and I don't know what to say. Drama llama. Let's do it.
Hard to say. Maybe she's rebelling against something. Or someone.
What would Rachel have to rebel against? We've given her everything she could ask for. Yet, I'm not sure I buy the narrative you laid out this morning in the principal's office. Rachel is not known for following along with anything she doesn't want to. I'd be lying if I said I didn't have concerns about your friendship, but perhaps you're exactly who Rachel needs right now as she navigates the choppy waters of adolescence.
Thanks.
Something else?
Okay.
Duty calls. Good chat, Mr. Amber.
Mm-hmm.
All right. Okay.
Yes, Chloe?
Sherry.
The boss man would like a sherry.
Thank you. The glasses are in the china cabinet. You can place one at his setting.
How am I supposed to get to China? Kidding. It's the fancy-looking cabinet, right?
You got it.
I bet Joyce would like our jokes. Not these people, though. They're polite enough. They're just...
It's the triangle-shaped one.
Basic shapes. Now you're speaking my language.
Yes, Chloe?
What else? Feel like I'm getting good at this.
Only one last step. As our guest, you may do the honor of lighting the candles. The lighter is in the-
It's cool. I've got my own.
Oh.
You never know when you'll need to light a candle, right?
You are a paragon of preparedness.
Thanks. I think. Time to
I think they're polite but disapproving.
And bless this joint up a bit. The Amber family and fire. What could possibly go wrong?
Oh, I guess that was the end. Crap, I probably missed something. I didn't think that would be the end. This is so awkward, oh my god.
So, Chloe, are you and Rachel in any of the same classes?
Not anymore! We just got expelled, yo!
This morning.
Oh, gosh. I'm so sorry.
Nah, that's cool. We're not.
What about that fire?
Dinner's really good, Mom.
Thank you, Rachel. The way the fire spreads so fast, I've never heard of anything like it.
Life sure is strange,
it's
isn't it?
Almost surreal. They say a fire like that could only come from a crime of passion.
Passion? What does that mean?
I don't know. You tell me. You're the DA, of course.
We're so bad.
It's certainly troubling. The latest report from the commissioner's office suggests arson.
Arson?
Chloe.
Why would anyone do that?
Any number of reasons. With everything going on in the world today, even a town like Arcadia Bay isn't immune to the ills of society.
I cannot imagine how difficult these last few years have been for you, Chloe. Now that you and Rachel have become friends, I want you to know that our home is always open to you.
Cool. Thanks.
Well said, dear. It's imperative in such troubled times as these that we remember what is most important to us. Family. Family's not merely a gift. It is a responsibility. As such, those we love must be cared for and never, ever taken for granted.
Alas, I don't know what to do. Let's do it. It's gonna be fun. Let's do it.
Enough of this asshole. Rachel may have to take it, but I don't. I'm going to turn his daughter and wife against him at his own.
Oh, this is a bad decision.
I'm not sure I agree.
This is bad. James.
Oh, I thought you of all people would be grateful for family, at least.
Gratitude seems like such a nice luxury. I can't say I've had the privilege to afford it.
That is an excellent point, Chloe. We must always be sensitive to the way our privileges shape our perspectives.
Well said, Mom.
Still, there must be some room for personal responsibility. I'm sure you agree, Chloe.
My dad was super responsible. He always drove under the speed limit. Then one day, a truck came along and turned him into a super responsible pancake.
See? This is why it's so important to invite diverse voices to converse with one.
The mom's just trying to, like, go along with it and, like, let it slide. And she's just like, let's just, we got this. And we'll just, yes. And then the dad's like.
Another.
This is hilarious. Absolutely stimulating. Super responsible pancake. I love it. Sounds like a hashtag right there. Super responsible.
Since you have answers
pancake.
For everything, Chloe, perhaps you'd like to enlighten us with some of your hard-earned wisdom about the world.
Sure. I believe that we should look closely at everyone, especially the people in power, to see what secrets they're hiding.
Very well articulated, Chloe. I am consistently impressed with how politically aware your generation is.
Chloe is an excellent articulator.
That sounds dirty.
Excuse me, dear? But if this is what passes for politically aware these days, we're in serious trouble.
James, that's unfair and also rude to Chloe.
No, I don't believe it is. It seems clear that these points Chloe is making are merely veiled attacks on me.
Are you suggesting that I'm using some sort of incognito mode where I can keep my activities hidden? That's crazy. Don't worry, Mr. Amber. I can tell that my progressive attitude is not welcome in this house. I'll see myself out.
James, Chloe is right. You owe her an apology.
I owe her no such thing. I believe she's willfully acting belligerently, just as she did this morning. It is how people like her respond to adversity.
People like her? So we're profiling now? This is what 8 months in the DA's office has taught you.
I resent that. My office is committed to fair and equitable treatment.
Yes, I've read the press releases.
Excuse me? Are you calling me a hypocrite? Rachel!
I can't sit here and listen to this bullshit anymore.
Rachel!
Stop it, Dad. You're a hypocrite, okay? I know. You lying, cheating, piece of shit, motherfucker.
Excuse me?
We saw you yesterday at the Overlook.
James?
Kissing that woman.
James.
Oh, Rachel, no.
Honey, whatever you saw or think you saw, I know it's hard, but I need you to trust me.
Think we saw? Are you trying to gaslight us? There's no thinking involved. We saw you locking lips with some other woman. Best part is,
She and I use the same drug dealer.
That's enough! You are not welcome here or around my daughter any longer. I know exactly what kind of person you are from the moment I saw you, and I let my wife's compassion get the better of you.
Oh? What kind of person is
a
that?
A delinquent. A broken girl from a broken home.
That's enough, James. I will not have you continue to speak to her like this.
Rachel's ready to blow. She's gonna set something else on fire. Oh no. Oh no. Oh no.
Why can't you just tell me the fucking truth? Stop lying! Stop being a politician for one fucking minute! Can't you just be my dad?
Rachel, that woman you saw.
That's just a waste of a good salad and a great dinner. It looked very tasty. My goodness, Rachel.
That wasn't my mistress.
Then
was your mother.
What? What? What is going on? What? Do they have an open relationship? What is happening? Why were they kissing? I don't know what's happening. Are you kidding me? No, you're not kidding me, are you? Oh my sweet good lord. Oh my. Destroy the middle. What?
From the perfect start to the finish line. And if you're still breathing, you're the lucky ones. Cause most of us are heaving through corrupted lungs, setting fire to our insides for fun. Collecting names off.
That sounds like an end of an episode. I'm kind of glad we took the time to do it, although honestly we should have split it up, but I didn't know. Oh, poor Joyce. Aww. She looks so worried. No.
Most of us are bitter.
Are they dating? I think I just saw that bitch smile. Like a little like smile like. Oh my god. I guess she does kind of look like Rachel now that I think of it. What is happening? Longest fucking episode I've ever uploaded. Shit. Okay. Well, guys, I just want to take a quick moment to say how much I was kind of doubting Life is Strange Before the Storm, kind of like the beginning of the first half of the second episode. I was like, this is almost ruining Life is Strange 1 for me. I was like, I'm not sure I even want to finish it. I don't think it's just not working for me. Like, it's kind of ruining how great Life is Strange 1 was for me. And then it just, I decided to give it more of a chance and to finish up the series. And then I can always play Life is Strange 1 again afterwards on my own time to get back some of that love for Life is Strange. But like, the last part of episode 2 just completely blew me out of the water. Like, there's some really good stuff in here. So I'm excited for episode 3. Jesus Christ, I'm excited. Oh my god, I'm so excited. Oh my goodness. Let's skip. Or exit. Oh. Oh, we refused to empty our pockets, which was rare. We took the blame for Rachel. Oh, shit. Oh, we're not making great choices at all. We gave Damon the money. Asked Rachel for a kiss. Yes. Okay.
Shit! Shit! Shit!
Oh no. Hell is empty. Chloe's story continues on the next episode. Buy more episodes now. Well, I'm so excited, guys. I hope you had fun watching this. I know this one is a little bit long, but I think there was a lot happening. It was a very entertaining. It was definitely worth the really long episode that it is. If it doesn't save, I'm literally going to kill myself. Like, sometimes game capture doesn't like to save things. So if this bitch doesn't save, I'm over it. I'm not going to... God, I would hate it if that happened, but... there's gonna be a nice little review after the end of Life is Strange Before the Storm. I'm excited for it, and I'm so excited for episode 3. We might have to play some this weekend, but we also have Life is Strange 2 to play, so I'm like, ah, there's so much to play, so much content, which is really lucky, because some people don't, like, some people have to wait, and then there's me, just overloaded, overwhelmed with all the wonderful stuff to play. So, thank you guys so much for watching, and until the next episode, I hope you guys have a great day. Bye, guys!